Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be going over a process builder, what process builders are, and how to use them. So process builders are a true false set of criteria on a single object that can perform certain tasks. So let's go ahead and do an opportunity process. Processes have to be on a single object and they can update any related records on other objects. So let's say if you were on an account, you could update a contact record or an opportunity record because opportunities and contacts are related to accounts. But let's go ahead and jump into an opportunity process. We're going to start it when a record changes. You do have a few other changes. You could do a platform event message is received, or it's invoked by another process. So what platform event message is received means, so let's say it's invoked by Apex or a flow, that type of deal. And if it's invoked by another process, it could be invoked by a like a completely unrelated thing. Maybe it's another opportunity process, or it could be like a task process or activity process. But we're going to do a record changes, click save. All right, and here it is a little bit more visual than workflow rule, and it's more concise than a flow. So I'm going to go to our object, opportunity, and we can choose it when a record is created or when it's created or edited. I'm gonna do the second one, then click save. So what we're gonna do here, as an example, we're going to be creating a renewal opportunity. So let's say we had a business, and one of the business requirements is one after an opportunity is closed, a year following that closure, we want our team, our customer success team, to follow up with that client and say, hey, we'd love to have you renew. So we're going to be creating a renewal opportunity. So we're going to have our criteria that's going to jump this off. To be it true is that stage is closed one. So stage equals close one. So this is just a criterion name. You want to make it easy for other people to just quickly look at it and see it and understand what it is. So I'm going to go opportunity stage equals pick list value closed one. All right, and that's all we're going to do for that. So what that's telling us is, so we're on the opportunity object. When a stage is moved to close one, then do this action. So let's set that action right now. You have a bunch of different options. As you can see here, we can create an email alert. We can do anything that's on the workflow rule, except for sending an outbound message. But you can do that, plus Apex, flows, posting chatter, etc. But what I'm going to do is create a record. So we're going to create renewal op. Not app, op. There we go. So now it's going to bring you up a bunch of different related things, related records, but we're just going to do another opportunity, keep it simple. Alright, so we have required fields that we have to have. This would be close date. This would be the name, stage, forecast category. Not necessary because it kind of already maps, but I'm going to put it into pipeline stage. So oftentimes when you have a renewal opportunity and it's going to the customer success team or whatever team it's going to be, they'll have new stages. But I'm just going to go to needs analysis as a name. We're going to do this. Do a renewal or do a formula for the name. I'm going to have it be renewal plus, and then I'm going to find the current opportunity name. So it's going to be renewal plus the opportunity name when you create that renewal opportunity. And then the close date, it will also be a formula field. We're going to take the old close date and then add 365, make it super simple. Plus 365. Use that, and hopefully, let's see, which one is that for? I'm thinking it's just the renewal opportunity. So let's put some quotes around it. Yep, there we go, and it's saved. So I'm gonna click activate, confirm, there we go. We just created a renewal opportunity process. So I'm gonna go and try to check it out, see if it works. Let's find an opportunity here. This isn't already closed one. Go into all opportunities. Here we go, we got one in qualification. I'm gonna click closed. Closed one. Save. And let's check to see the account. It is not there. But here we have it. It is closed one. Other things that we might need to do to it is attach it to the account in the process builder. But there you have it. Be sure to like and subscribe. And I have more videos like this in my app builder course. Be sure to check that out in the description down below. And I'll catch you guys in the next one.